This video we shall walk through the key concepts and features you need to know of TypeScript when building large scale applications that uses JavaScript. Here comes the agenda for this video. First, I'll discuss the reason we need TypeScript and the problems we are facing as developers when working with JavaScript code. After that, we shall see what TypeScript actually is. Then we shall go into a bit detail to know the features of TypeScript. We shall later see what TypeScript has to offer if you are a JavaScript developer. And then I'll talk about the TypeScript compiler. We have a few important keywords in TypeScript you may be interested to know about. We shall look into the tooling options and the support we have for writing TypeScript code and then converting it into JavaScript. And at the end, we shall create a small working sample of a Hello World application using TypeScript. So that's the agenda for this video, and let us start now. Now, the big question is, why do we need to write TypeScript when we can write custom JavaScript? The question is interesting, and many of us would ask it ourselves. We know the pain that comes along when we have to write or learn a new language every now and then. But wait, there is a genuine reason. To find out the need to use TypeScript, we first need to understand the problems we face today with JavaScript. You may call it as challenges instead of problems, in fact. If you have written a lot of JavaScript when working on your applications, one of the important things you might already be aware is that if you do not really follow a pattern when writing and structuring the JavaScript code, you end up in problems over a period of time. You keep iterating and writing JavaScript code again and again, and the application keeps growing and your JavaScript actually starts feeling messy. You start modifying it in one place and it starts impacting in a different way. Next, once the code starts becoming messy, it becomes very difficult to maintain your JavaScript code. And of course, you can write pure JavaScript and write it very clean to avoid the messy code. However, like you might have to follow a pattern like prototype or some other, but none of them are so easy to follow, as you know. TypeScript can help you write maintainable code. And now if your application only has a few hundred lines of code or even less, you may not have to use TypeScript at all. I'm not saying that TypeScript is the only option we have. You may always write your JavaScript for small applications. I want to make this very clear, like TypeScript is not a replacement for JavaScript. You can decide whether to use TypeScript or not depending on the size and complexity involved for writing JavaScript in your application. One thing is true, like if you are working on a huge enterprise level application which involves writing a lot of JavaScript, TypeScript can help you to a great extent in saving your time and also to make your code more maintainable. An important thing to know is JavaScript provides a dynamic type system. It has both pros and cons. First, let us see the good ones. Variables can hold any object. That means variables can hold boolean values, string or integers, or even object literals and other values. Like, it is really cool and flexible. Next, types are determined on the fly in JavaScript. It is an excellent feature. You don't have to specify it explicitly. So I personally like this feature very much. And next, we get implicit type conversion, and that's a cool feature to have. For example, you have a string number in quotes and if you compare it to the literal number in an if statement, the type is converted implicitly. That can save you a lot of time, but again, like we have a bad thing coming in for each of the good ones here. So like variables can hold any object. That this means it is difficult for you as a developer to ensure whether you passed in proper types or not without actually checking it everywhere. You may need to write a lot of unit test cases in order to make your life easy. Next. Types are determined on the fly. So, when you want to compare two variables of different types having the same value, it becomes difficult. Mostly, if you use double equals to compare two variables, like this is what I have seen personally, like mostly all the developers use double equals to compare two variables. But the conversion takes place inside. It can give you incorrect results in many cases. Like if you want to compare variables and their types too, you must use triple equals actually. And I know most of the developers simply use double equals, ignoring this fact. If you use three equals, a string 1 and a number 1 will never be equal. And big gaps can have a lot of JavaScript code, and the variables, types and conversions can start becoming messy. Like very soon. To start with, the JavaScript will be simple, and after you keep iterating over a period of time, you end up with so much of code and a lot of problems in hand. This is a common thing I have experienced at least. And when developers move from desktop apps, Java, PHP or Ruby code, they might not be knowing much about JavaScript initially. But TypeScript can help them, as the developers will at least be aware of the concepts and some syntaxes which is common with TypeScript and other languages. No, this is not a justification not to learn or use JavaScript, but this is another way to write JavaScript, like with more easily and with less problems. Also, there are a few other alternative ways you can use to get rid of the problems I just mentioned. So you can always write pure JavaScript if you think you can maintain it easily. Or you may also want to follow a few patterns when writing JavaScript. That is not a bad idea too. There is an alternative called CoffeeScript. Just visit coffeescript.org and you may find that interesting too. And of course Google has Dart, which is another alternative which can help you generate clean and maintainable JavaScript. As you see here, like there are different alternatives for writing clean and maintainable code, but in this video I'll focus mainly on the TypeScript, which is becoming popular these days. TypeScript offers classes, modules and interfaces to help you build robust components. Okay, let us now see the official definition for TypeScript. TypeScript is a free and open source programming language developed by Microsoft. So, TypeScript is a language for application scale JavaScript development. TypeScript is a typed superset of JavaScript that compiles to plain JavaScript. It is clear from the definition, like TypeScript is a superset of JavaScript, it's not a replacement, and it is not a separate language as well. Like in TypeScript you may use keywords which are not in JavaScript. However, like you can just paste your plain JavaScript when writing code in TypeScript, and that works. It's guaranteed. The thing is that you write TypeScript code and you end up getting JavaScript code after compilation. First, let us look into the options and features provided by TypeScript. A good thing about the TypeScript is that it works on any browser. You use Firefox, Internet Explorer, Chrome or Safari. TypeScript just works everywhere. It works on all major operating system, and that's a bonus. TypeScript is open source. Yes, you can contribute. You may read the specifications on website if you like to contribute and join the community. Like you may also play with the code bits and file bugs on their QA site as well. Next, the important thing is TypeScript has a great tool support. Not only Visual Studio, but TypeScript works on many other editors, including the popular Sublime Editor. And any JavaScript developer looking for modularity will like TypeScript. TypeScript supports JavaScript code. So what it means is that you don't have to write everything in TypeScript. You can use a little TypeScript and write code with your regular JavaScript as well. Like you can mix and match. You can work on JavaScript and TypeScript all at the same time. TypeScript supports static typing. That is a very important feature. So you can catch a lot of errors happening when you pass incorrect types as parameters. You can catch them through the tools or through the compilation process. You don't have to wait till the testers report bugs, but find it during development. So that is a great feature. And another interesting thing is that TypeScript provides encapsulation. You can use naming containers called modules. You can write classes. If you are from an object-oriented programming background, you will find it interesting. And also, like, you can apply the same skills you already know about when writing TypeScript code. In addition to that, you can define interfaces for having contracts. You can use constructors in your classes, and also, like, interfaces are not there in JavaScript, but you can use it with TypeScript, and that opens up a lot of possibilities. And one more, if you are from a C# background, you will find that TypeScript has support for lambdas. Like, this is a very helpful feature to write anonymous functions and when you write callbacks. And you can get IntelliSense syntax checking, and you can instantly find errors in your code. So these are the important features of TypeScript. There are many other features too, but these are the ones you will be using more often. Now let us have a look at the TypeScript architecture. The TypeScript code files will have a .ts extension, and there is a TypeScript compiler. You write code in TypeScript and then you compile it. Once you compile your TypeScript code, the output will be the JavaScript code. Interesting, isn't it? Like, you write TypeScript, you compile it using the command, and after compiling you will get the JavaScript as output. You can always use the compiler and compile using a command line by hitting a command tsc space your file name dot ts. The code would simply compile and output the JavaScript file. You then just reference this JavaScript in your web application and start using it, just like you do with any other JavaScript file. It is clean and simple. Like, if you are using tools like Visual Studio, you don't even have to worry about compiling or using command line tools. You start writing code and the Visual Studio will on the fly generate JavaScript from TypeScript code. TypeScript code looks something like you have already seen on an object-oriented language. Just observe the code here. We have a class called greeter. We have a variable called greeting, which has a type of string. So we have static type support here. And we have support for defining a constructor, and we are passing a message. So also, like, we have a simple function called greet, which just returns a message. Now, when you compile this TypeScript, the output will be this JavaScript on the right side. The output is a standard JavaScript. You get a greeter object, a wrapper function. We have the constructor here called greeter, and it takes a parameter message. We got a prototype here, if you see, to extend the greeter with a greet message. And it returns exactly the greeting message with a hello prefix, just like you see on the left side. Now, just think once again. How do you want to go writing JavaScript? Taking the TypeScript approach can save a lot of time, isn't it? Now, like, let us talk about the syntax. So, TypeScript is a superset of JavaScript. So that means TypeScript follows the same syntax rules that of JavaScript. You can use brackets to define code blocks. You can end your code with semicolons. And your JavaScript keywords for looping and conditions still holds good in TypeScript, because TypeScript is just a superscript of superset of JavaScript. Like, here are a few important keywords you will use more often when working with TypeScript. TypeScript supports class for encapsulation here, and we have a keyword for defining the constructor. Then we have modules in TypeScript, so we have a keyword for it. So modules can export different members, so we have this keyword. And we can extend a class or interface using the extends keyword. We can do inheritance through this keyword, and we can use the interface keyword to define interfaces. Like, also we can use implements keyword here to implement an interface. You can import a module using the import keyword mentioned here. Also, you can use the public and private visibility modifiers for your members. And okay, like, we also have operators, three dots here, which actually helps you to pass a comma separated list of items in your code. So I think this is also a useful stuff. So, and the important thing is we have the arrow syntax for callbacks, and also to define functions, or when you are implementing interfaces, you can always use this keyword. It's like, if you go to the TypeScript website, you will find more details on this. And we have a less than and a greater than operator, like symbols, for doing the casting. And last not the least, the colon separator we have can be used between the name of variables and between parameter names and types. So these are the most important keywords you will be using more often when you are working on TypeScript. In TypeScript, we have a defined hierarchy, unlike JavaScript. Like, in TypeScript, we can have a naming container called module. Inside module, the key thing you will have is a class inside a module. The class will again be a container for fields, constructors, properties and functions. And you see here, classes can implement interfaces. So, like, this is the overall hierarchy, like, you will notice when working with TypeScript applications. Okay, now the best thing about TypeScript is its tooling support. Tools can help you compile your TypeScript and can also help you to figure out the problems upfront and prevent you from spending hours of time debugging your JavaScript. Like, TypeScript can directly be used with Node.js. It supports, TypeScript also has a support for Sublime, which is a very popular editor. It has support for Emacs on the Mac, and it has support for the VI. And one cool thing for developers is, like, Visual Studio has excellent support for TypeScript. So you start typing TypeScript code, you save it, the JavaScript file is automatically generated. Like, another cool thing is the TypeScript playground. Actually, you can just open the TypeScript website, start typing your code there, and you get a lot of support for catching errors on the fly, JavaScript generation and more. Like, let me show that right now, how to use the TypeScript playground. Okay, open up your favorite browser and go to typescriptlang.org. So this is the official TypeScript webpage, and here you see a lot of learning stuff. You can get the TypeScript downloaded here, you can try some examples, and you can join into for the community and things like that. And first, like, to enter the TypeScript playground, just click on the play menu here. Okay, So the TypeScript playground is loaded and it is ready. And the first thing you will see is there is some code already here. At the left side you see the code written in TypeScript, and at the right we see the JavaScript code, which is the output after compiling the left side TypeScript. So in the playground, like as and when you start writing your TypeScript code, the code automatically gets compiled and the JavaScript output will be displayed here, and you can run the output on and see the output of your code. Okay, that's not everything about it actually. So we have a drop down here, like Microsoft has made it very easy for you guys to start learning TypeScript. You see a lot of examples here to learn classes, modules and other things. By default, like, the classes are loaded here. Okay, so first in this code you will observe, like, we have a class called greeter, and we have a variable called greeting of type string. So we have a constructor taking a message and assigning it here, and we also have a function to greet. The greet function will just output the greeting appended with a hello text. Okay, so now let us try to add one more function here. So let us do it the JavaScript way. So I'll write a function, say for example function 1. I'll open the bracket. You notice that the bracket is getting closed automatically. That happens even with the floor brackets. And you notice here, as and when I start typing something, the code is getting compiled and the output is displayed here. So here you see immediately we have a line in red here. So there is a highlight, and that says there is some problem with the function. Actually, the thing is that the syntax for creating a TypeScript function is not valid. Of course, you can always put that outside your class. So if you want to add your own JavaScript functions and other things, you can add that outside the class here. So this is a valid thing. So as you notice that we have a pretty good highlight here on the function, which indicates that there is some sort of error. So now let us add a valid function called test, and let me open that up. So now I'll return some value, and now let us see, like, we the support for IntelliSense. So I just typed this and I pressed a dot, and you see that the playground is providing a very good IntelliSense. I can select the things here, or say for example, like, intentionally I'll try to do some mistake here by removing this, and I'll simply say this dot greeting. Okay, so immediately there is a highlight here showing, like, there is some error here. The thing is that I just missed this plus. Okay, now it should be solved. In the code here outside the class, we are just creating an instance of this greeter class, and we are creating a button with some text on it, and on click of the button we are actually greeting the user with an alert message, and we are adding the button to the body so that it gets displayed. So you notice some things here, like as and when I select the class here, like, we see the highlights going on here, and you just saw so many help for finding out the errors in case you do some mistakes while typing the code. So let me remove this off, and in this example I'll show you how to run that. You just click on the run button and you get the say hello button. You click on it, you see the output hello world. Now I will show you a demo of how to use TypeScript with Visual Studio. First, go to the TypeScript website. You need to install TypeScript on your machine if you don't want to work with the playground. So click on the get it link here. So here you will see a lot of different options to download TypeScript. So in this case, like I have Visual Studio 2012 installed on my machine, so I'll click on download the plugin here. So you'll be taken to Microsoft Download Center. Like example, when you write some code in TypeScript, and as and when you save, you want to convert it into a JavaScript, and also you need some functions like to see TypeScript and JavaScript code both at a time. So in order to get those options, like go to the Tools menu in Visual Studio, click on the extension and add updates. So select online, and from the Visual Studio gallery we can install Web Essentials 2012 and download it here. So Web Essentials 2012 will have a lot of things. It will add a lot of features to Visual Studio. In this case, like it will add save on if you save the TypeScript, it will automatically convert to JavaScript. And also, like you will get a window wherein you can see both TypeScript and JavaScript together. That is really helpful, like if you are writing your TypeScript code. Let me close this. I think it is installed. I'll restart my browser. I'll restart my editor. Now let us create a new project. So I'll create a web, and I'll create a ASP.NET empty web application. I'll just double click on it. Okay, project has been created. Now I'll just add a new folder for my scripts. So now you can right click on that and add a new TypeScript file here, or you can even add it here. So let me search for TypeScript. So select the TypeScript file here, and the name I have given is index.ts. I'll click on the add button. Okay. You see here, like when we create the new TypeScript file, we have some code by default. If you don't want, you can always remove it. This is just an example. Also, you see, like we have a window coming in here. So this, the left side window shows you the TypeScript code, and the right side one shows you the compiled Java output of TS, that is the JavaScript file. So just see here, like as and when I modify something here, and I save it, I should be getting the output here, the modified one. So let us do one thing. Let us try to paste some code and see how it works. So I'll open back the TypeScript website. And I'll go to the playground. Playground has some running code already. So I'll just copy that. And let me paste that here, and I'll save that. Okay, as in when I save, like you see the code has changed here. So now what we can do is we can actually run this. So let me run it. I'll just move this code here. What I'll do is just add a HTML file. HTML file, I'll add a reference to this JavaScript file. Just drag and drop here. Okay, so that's all I had to do. Let me try running this web page now. I got the message here. Let me click here. I see the message, "Hello world." Here I have a few references on TypeScript. So you can visit typescriptlang.org to find everything about TypeScript. And TypeScript is also on CodePlex. You can visit typescript.codeplex.com. Thank you for watching this video.